Well, good morning, everybody. I am George Devries, Chairman, President, CEO, and co-founder of American Specialty Health. And I would like to welcome you to our press conference. I'd like to offer a special welcome to Governor Pence and thank you for joining us, as well as Mayor Brainard from Carmel. I'd like to welcome members of the media, as well as other friends. We have an announcement this morning regarding American Specialty Health and our plans in the city of Carmel and in the state of Indiana. But first, I'd like to give you a bit of an introduction to American Specialty Health, who we are as an organization. American Specialty Health is one of those true entrepreneurial startups. We started 26 years ago, 1987, out in Southern California. And at the time, it was I started it along with two co-founders, a few thousand dollars, working out of a second bedroom in the condo my wife and I had at the time. It was really a dream, a desire to build a company inside of the healthcare industry that would truly provide quality programs, try to help health plans manage cost and quality of healthcare. And that's really how we started. We decided we'd focus on specialty areas of healthcare, ancillary areas that maybe others weren't spending too much attention on. We started with chiropractic, and in Southern California, in California at the time, HMOs weren't covering chiropractic, so we created a program that would help health plans in California to offer chiropractic. Well, that program took off, and it began to grow. By 7 years later, by about early, mid-1990s, we decided we really wanted to elevate our organization, become a full partner in the healthcare industry. So we set out to become a fully licensed specialty health plan in California. And we did that within a couple of years, going through the regulatory process. And what that did was the proverbial Y in the road in the history of the company, where we had to elevate what we did. Everything from information technology to financial management, to reporting, to all the capabilities it takes to create a truly effective healthcare organization this day and age. And that was the why in the road for us, and it was mission critical for us because everything we've done since then has been with that level of focus on quality and service. As we took our organization forward over the coming years, we began a process of national expansion outside of California, going national in all 50 states. We also began a process of diversification. We began to work with other specialty and ancillary provider groups, working with physical therapy, occupational therapy, acupuncture, massage therapy, nutrition, dietetics, and others. And we continued to build our program across the country. We are very, very fortunate working with many, many health plans from across the country. We then began to expand our programs into other business units, other product lines. We expanded into population health, providing prevention and wellness and other kinds of disease management and health coaching programs. Then we also expanded into areas of fitness and exercise, working particularly with Medicare Advantage plans, helping them to provide unique programs for seniors covered under those programs. Today, 26 years later, American Specialty Health, we cover 34 million people across the country, serving membership in all 50 states. We work with over 130 different health plans across the country. Companies you would know, like Anthem, Kaiser, and others. Working directly with employer groups like Cummins Corporation and Neiman Marcus and others. So we've had the opportunity to truly build a national footprint. We have over 1,000 employees inside of our organization. But as we've moved our company forward, we've found the need to ensure that we're a national, truly a national company with a presence across the country. And that brought us to a process where we began to look at what was best for the organization as we grew going forward for the next 10 to 20 years. And as we looked at that strategy, we said we needed to have multiple offices. So we'll keep our office in San Diego. We will, last year we opened an office, a full operations center in the Dallas, Texas area in South Lake, Texas. And as you can see here, we're in the process of opening an office here in Carmel, Indiana, and it'll be one of three major operation centers for us nationwide. But it goes, I think, a bit further than that. We're very pleased to announce today that we will not only have a major corporate operations center here in the Carmel, Indiana area, but we will also be relocating our national corporate headquarters to Carmel, Indiana. And we're very excited about it. In the initial phase, we're going to occupy over 16,000 square feet of office space at the Carmel Tech Center, and that begins this September. And that is going to, we're going to occupy that space while upgrades are being made here at Hamilton Crossing 2. And we actually will have in excess of 72,000 square feet in this building. So we'll start with a total of about 90,000 square feet. But we do expect that to expand over time, since our goal is basically by the end of 2016, we expect to have 675 full-time employees here operating out of these offices. Thank you. We're very excited about it. We think State of Indiana, Carmel, Indiana, offer tremendous advantages for American Specialty Health moving forward as an organization. You know, we look at the state of Indiana, we look at Carmel, Indiana, and we see here just a wonderful place to do business. State of Indiana has a terrific reputation and has just done a great job supporting the business community. We appreciate that. I want to thank Governor Pence, I want to thank Mayor Brainard. As we've been just working on, first and foremost, opening the operations office, we've been greeted with just open arms. The carpet's truly been rolled out for our organization, and it's showed us what a business-friendly environment this is. The second part of it is, as we look at our employees, and our employees are the backbone of our company, and we certainly want to be able to attract best employees we can and give them a quality of life that's good for them. We see in the state of Indiana, we see in Carmel, Indiana, an ability for our employees to have a quality of life that's just exceptional. Affordable housing, low taxes, outstanding public schools, wonderful community, both Carmel and the greater Indianapolis area. So we're excited for just being part of the Carmel and Indianapolis community, part of the state of Indiana. I'm excited personally. This is a bit of coming home for me. I grew up in the state of Iowa, a small town in Iowa, born in a town of 95, grew up in a town of a few thousand, and was fortunate enough to receive almost a full scholarship to the Culver Academies for high school. And went to Culver, up in Culver, Indiana, and I've had two sons who've graduated recently from Culver and know Indiana well, and I'm excited to not only will call Carmel, Indiana, and state of Indiana, our corporate headquarters, but for me personally, it'll be home going forward. So,
thank you very much.
Well, thank you all for being here. Thank you to George Devries. Welcome home.
Thank you.
It is a joy to be able to be a part of welcoming American Specialty Health here to the Hoosier State. I'm grateful for the leadership, George, of your company. You are. I don't want to flatter you, but you're one of those great American success stories. Small town guy comes to a great state to go to Culver. Right? Gets a background in the education, has a dream, starts with a couple people. Now for 26 years, American Specialty Health has become a national company in a critical area of American healthcare, and we just commend you and are excited about this announcement today. Especially grateful for a number of public officials who are here. Mayor Jim Brainard, the energetic mayor of Carmel, Indiana, who keeps us moving. Give him a round of applause. This is, I get a real joy out of Mayor Fisher. And it is an honor for the state of Indiana, and I know for this community, as the mayor will no doubt share momentarily, to be able to be some small part of this important announcement today by American Specialty Health. The participation of the state of Indiana would not be possible but for the strong support of our economic development efforts, led in part by our Secretary of Commerce, Victor Smith, who is with us. We are joined today by two members of the Indiana General Assembly, George, whose support for our economic development efforts make days like this possible all over the state of Indiana. And I want to thank Senator Mike Delf and Representative Jerry Torr for your strong support for jobs and economic development in Indiana. You know, George, as the chairman and CEO of American Specialty Health, you've provided inspiring leadership and brought this this opportunity for the people of Indiana and for this great community. And I'm here to express my heartfelt welcome and my heartfelt appreciation to you and to this great company. It's 73,000 square foot office space along with 16,000 square feet Carmel Tech Center. It's going to be a great addition to this community and a great addition to the vitality of this region. And let me also say how exciting it is, knowing about your presence on the West Coast and in Texas, that this is not just a decision to bring 675 new jobs to Indiana. This is about bringing the headquarters of American Specialty Health to the Hoosier State. And that's a big, big deal. You've chosen wisely, making your headquarters here in Indiana and expanding your business in the Hoosier State. The principles of your company, your commitment to quality and service that are evident throughout your organization, the highest caliber and quality, like the healthcare coverage that you provide and maintain every day, is going to be met with a community that cherishes all of those values and principles. American Specialty Health, as I said, was founded back in 1987. Now administers benefit programs to 31 million members and reported $221 million in revenue last year, which was a 64% increase in 2009. Inc. 500 has named American Specialty Health to its list of the fastest growing privately held companies 5 years in a row, and we look forward to that growth continuing to happen right here in the Hoosier State. Hoosiers will now join the ranks of your more than 1,000 American Specialty Health Associates around the country, and we're profoundly grateful. Since 2009, the Indiana Economic Development Corporation has worked, you might be glad to know, with 20 California-based companies that have made plans to relocate, consolidate, or grow here in the Hoosier State. This has accounted for over 3,200 jobs in Indiana and over $211 million in investment in Indiana. This is what we call in our office a good start, should not come as a big surprise. George, I appreciate your kindness about the Hoosier State, but Indiana's record of fiscal responsibility, our commitment to creating a pro-business environment of common sense regulations, low taxes, even while we invest in infrastructure and education, innovation, reform, has won us accolades. Recently ranked number 5 nationally by Chief Executive Magazine, the number 1 best place in the Midwest to do jobs. I am grateful to have you express the affirmation that it's been the policies, the practices that Indiana has demonstrated, our commitment to fiscal discipline and pro-growth, the forward thinking of communities like Carmel, Indiana, that are a result in part of your decision to come here. But we know who deserves most of the credit. You've already acknowledged all of your wonderful associates around the country. I do know that based on your rich experience here in the Hoosier State, we know you're coming to Indiana, not just because we have a great pro-business environment, not just because we have great communities, but frankly because Hoosiers are the best people on earth. And I just know that the decision of American Specialty Health here is reflective of your appreciation, having spent some of your formative years in Indiana, having had almost 3 of your kids also get degrees at that great institution. You know what Hoosiers are made of. It's about hard work. It's about integrity. It's about providing the kind of service and the kind of work product that I know makes Indiana companies work, and I know it's going to make this company prosper as well. So on behalf of the people of Indiana, with great credit to the people of Indiana, let me say one more time to George DeVries, to the team at American Specialty Health, to the mayor and all those gathered here. Indiana today proves once again, by welcoming this headquarters to the Hoosier State from the West Coast, that Indiana is open for business. And we're grateful for having the opportunity to prove that one more time.
I want to officially welcome American Specialty Health to Carmel community. Voted the number one best place to live in the United States by Money Magazine last year. And we so much appreciate the governor's time to be here with us today and the support the state has given to American Specialty Health and the City of Carmel in helping us work together with American Specialty Health for this move. I also see, I'd be remiss if I didn't recognize Chris Carmen, who's standing out in the hallway as well, from Carmen Real Estate, who worked so tirelessly to help make this day possible. I've thoroughly enjoyed working with the executive team and staff in American Specialty Health during the past few months. This is a company, well, let me tell you a story. The first time I walked into their office in San Diego, I saw up in the lobby, just like out here, award after award about best place to work in San Diego. And so we knew that from the very beginning that we were dealing with a company that was proud of its workforce and took care of its workforce. And we're particularly pleased that a company of this caliber has chosen to relocate to Carmel. You've already heard this new corporate headquarters in Carmel will employ approximately 675 employees by 2016. And I'm also excited that key executives from the California office have decided to move to Carmel after experiencing what we have to offer. Same time as wonderful news for Aloha economy, the majority of the jobs created here will be filled by employees and professionals from this area. I believe Carmel has been able to help attract companies. Of course, Indiana's a great place to be a city in these days, but we're fortunate to attract companies because of the high quality of life here, created by a strong sense of community, our expanding park system, the variety of cultural amenities, our schools, library, and first-rate workforce. Since the beginning of 2013, in the last 8 months, Carmel has worked with companies that have chosen to move or expand here that will add more than 3,300 jobs over the next 5 years, which is roughly a 6% increase in our total employment base in just 8 months. And just as these companies continue to grow here, we will continue to grow our community amenities as we complete our new downtown, our city center, as we enhance the arts and design district in the older part of Carmel and redevelop the Midtown area. And we will complete these redevelopment projects as we always have in a fiscally responsible manner in order to keep Carmel's taxes among the lowest in Hamilton County, one of the lowest in the state of Indiana, and the United States. And we feel our growth is attributable to the fact that we work with the private sector to create a very livable, sustainable community for just not our generation, but for the generations to come, so that our children and grandchildren want to call Carmel home as well. I'm thrilled to welcome AISH, American Specialty Health, to Carmel, and look forward to growing together for many years. Congratulations.
Well, again, I'd like to just say on behalf of American Specialty Health how excited we are to be part of the state of Indiana, Carmel, Indiana community. We're excited to be here. you know, my original remarks, and I want the focus to be on the fact that, you know, the state of Indiana is just a tremendous place to run a business and to do business, and we're excited to be here and to be able to have better access to our clients across the country. The city of Carmel, city of Indianapolis, and surrounding areas provide a tremendous quality of life for our employees, and we are so excited about that. But I'd be remiss if I didn't thank the Governor Pence and the state of Indiana for all you're doing to help us. It's expensive to do these kind of things, as it is for any company. We're investing over $10 million in our infrastructure to build out our offices, put in duplicate data centers, do the things we're doing. And I want to say thank you, Governor Pence, and to state of Indiana, that we have been, as an organization, provided with tax credits of $11,500,000 and additional grants of $250,000 for a total amount of $11,750,000. And so really want to thank you for that. It's a terrific part of our opportunity to be here and become part of the Indiana and Indiana business community. With that, we'd like to finish and again thank all of you for joining us today. We will be here, Governor Pence and Mayor Brainard and myself. We're going to, if you want to come up and you have any questions, please come up and ask us individually, but thank you very much.